Hello and welcome to our webinar, Why Firms Are Banking on Relationship Intelligence for Prospect and Client Management. I'm Michelle Daly, Head of Demand Generation at Affinity, and I'm joined today by Affinity Product Marketing Manager, Reanesh Kanaganayagam, and Product Manager, Jamie Fronckowiak. Before we get started, just a few housekeeping notes. We will be recording today's webinar and we'll be sending the recording to all registrants after the event. If you have any questions, you can submit them at any time, and we'll be answering those offline after the webinar as well as during the webinar. And with that, over to Reanesh and Jamie.
Thanks, Michelle, and welcome everyone. Today we're talking about business development and the unique needs of those in relationship-driven businesses like investment banking. Jamie, we talk a lot about relationship intelligence here at Affinity. What is relationship intelligence and how are customers using it in their business development?
Great question, Reanesh. So relationship intelligence is all about the data and the sentiment between your business and a prospect. Affinity Relationship Intelligence is tailor-made for dealmakers to deliver insights and confidence without the data drudgery of CRMs. For our customers and business development functions, Affinity provides insights on prospect lists by enriching them with context. If you caught our recent webinar with Corporate Advisory Solutions, Michael Lamb, one of our CAS co-founders and managing partners talked about how in one day of using Affinity, their active database more than doubled.
Yeah, I remember that. That was a really significant increase. And so today we're going to talk to you about how teams are doing this, specifically how they are using Affinity to accelerate efforts from enriching and managing prospects lists to growing relationships that result in successful client relationships. Today, we're pulling prospects from all sorts of places, from articles and newsletters, people we meet at conferences, directly from PitchBook, et cetera. Jamie, how are teams managing these different leads across all of their sources? How can I manage all of my prospects and what value does having them together create?
Yeah, so I'm gonna share my screen a little bit. So the great thing about Affinity is that it goes where you go. So you could be looking at an article around up and coming enterprise tech companies, which is maybe the area that you focus on. You stumble upon a company, we'll say Funnel.io. Naturally, you're going to go to their website in order to learn more information. So using Affinity's Pathfinder tool, right from where you are, you're able to see whether or not your firm has any relationships. It looks like we don't, so this is probably a good fresh prospect to go ahead and add to our prospecting list. This prospecting list is a really great centralized source of truth for your business development teams in order to bring in all information about prospects that they've identified, whether that's importing lists from PitchBook or other sources. We also have an integration with SourceScrub where you can send your list directly to Affinity with one click. And finally, the mobile app is also a great on-the-go tool to cross-reference whether or not you have a relationship with the company and add them to this list.
Nice. Historically, I know that investment bankers have used notepads and Excel files to keep track of notes on their prospects, but digital transformation has been a priority for some time. For those that haven't yet adopted a CRM technology, why is it important that they make that change now?
Yeah, so investment banking, particularly the boutiques, it's a highly competitive market. We've also seen that they're relatively slower to adopt new technology vis-a-vis other financial and professional services firms. So we're really at this inflection point. Firms need to either learn or lean into AI and machine learning powered tools like Affinity, or they're gonna risk falling behind. And this has only been exacerbated by the pandemic. Traditionally, these are travel intensive industries, and now they're suddenly grounded. And having the right technology stack has really proved invaluable. When you can walk over to a colleague's office or take a prospect to dinner, there's a different kind of landscape there. And you can no longer do that as efficiently. And so technology becomes even more important for remote collaboration and for relationship building. So with Affinity, firms like CAS were able to transition into this new world without skipping a beat. Using relationship intelligence, CAS could efficiently stay on top of their target markets, which ultimately helped them make better decisions. In a recent webinar with Michael Lamb, he said that now, even with travel restrictions lifted, CAS is able to make more intelligent decisions on whether or not a prospect is good before they travel.
That's a really great point, Jamie. The pandemic truly shifted how businesses operated overnight. it's really interesting to see a lot of these new practices sticking and even improving business development practices as things open back up. Another change we've seen is the emergence of more hybrid and remote teams. And it seems like this is another thing that may stick at least for a while. For those that are sourcing across teams and channels, how are they using relationship intelligence to inform their BD efforts? I imagine it can get a little messy.
Definitely. Again, especially when you can't just walk over to your colleague's office to see whether or not they have a relationship with a company, you start to hear more and more of these horror stories that existed before the pandemic but have really been exacerbated. So imagine you're a new team member and you're trying to quickly make your mark. So maybe you bring over contacts from your former firm or long-term relationships that you've had and reach out to them to try and spur new business. Only after reaching out do you realize that one of your new colleagues has actually been working on that person as a lead for months. And so not only have you tarnished your reputation, you've potentially negated months of work put in by your colleague. And again, it's a really competitive and relationship-driven market. A founder can easily go to another firm who personally knows him or her better. And it's really painful to hear those stories when it's so easy to prevent with Affinity. You can search for any company or person very easily and go to their profile in order to see relevant information about your team's communication with that company. So you can really easily see with Gong, for example, that there's a lot of communication happening already between your colleagues and this firm. You can also see that they've been added to your prospecting list. And in fact, there's an engagement letter signed already on a buy-side deal. So definitely don't reach out to this one.
Yeah, that's a really great example. So let's shift gears a little bit. Let's say you've used Affinity to consolidate all of your prospects together, but we also know that closing a deal in investment banking is a years-long process. How does Affinity help accelerate business development?
Great question. So the centralized context and shared history are crucially important, not just for visibility on contacts across your organization, but also for providing a place for you to personally streamline and scale your business development efforts. So you can really easily create a particular view where you filter on yourself as owner and are able to see just your prospects. And there's a lot of great tools for you to use in order to stay on top of those relationships. You can take notes, you can fill out reminders after having a conversation with, say, Loom, for example. Maybe they're not quite ready for that next step, but they said in a month follow up, and you just want to make sure that you're staying on top of that. Previously, you're putting fake calendar items up. Here, you can bring all of those reminders into one place, and they're going to automatically go off once you hit that timeline. We also have this feature called reminder triggers, which is going to be really helpful, especially for those relationships that have been formed, but they're just not ready to do a big deal, maybe a sell side deal. And it's going to be 2, 3, 4, 5 years until that founder is really ready. And this is a really tough spot to manage this relationship, make sure that you're staying on top of it. And so with reminder triggers, you can actually identify based on a particular status. So say, you know, we formed that relationship, they're just not quite ready. You can focus on deals that are just yours and say, okay, I want to make sure that no matter